How to get out of Google Sandbox. I did a video about Google Sandbox two days ago. So if you didn't watch that video, you can watch it after this. I have explained what Google Sandbox is. So let's say your website is in the Google Sandbox, right? I have prepared a small presentation for you guys and with examples as well. So watch this to the end. You will get out of Google Sandbox after doing these steps. Okay, so when you want to go out of or get out of Google Sandbox, right? First method is find low competitive keywords, right? What that means. The thing is, normally your website goes inside Google Sandbox when your website is new, when your website has no authority, especially when you go after competitive big searches, right? So when a website is coming without any backlinks, no any history, no one mentioned your website name, no one linked to your website, yeah, that's what I said, no backlinks. So when other thing is your website is really optimized, you know, like for some keywords, they ask these keywords are competitive. Google really strict about this stuff. Especially I have seen this, it happens your money, your life niches. So UML, right? Your money or your life. So health or money and other, these really, really competitive niches, right? So even your website is in competitive niche, right? You need to find some low competitive keywords, right? So to find low competitive keywords, you can go to Quora and check those questions, right? It works, so I can show you. It's great if you can find keywords people even haven't targeted properly. When the keyword is really, really long, especially questions, right? No one actually care about this stuff because the keyword is so big and really less searches. When we do keyword research with some keyword tools, href or key search or SEMrush and all the keywords, they even say zero. So this is why these keywords are still free to go. Okay, so let's go to Quora. Let's say your website is on health, right? So lose fat, okay? And I will search, sort of example, I had actually a website, how to lose fat from face. Okay, so how to lose fat from face. You can see some suggestions, right? How do I lose body fat? Not body fat, I'm not talking about. How do I lose fat? Okay, just check this one. Okay, super. So you can see related questions, right? There are so many words in one question, okay? So let's say, why do I have chubby cheeks even though I am skinny? Okay, let's get that one. Normally these are not competitive. I have done many, many times. Okay. Okay, so you can see that exact question coming right away, right? So you can see even domain authority 18, but it ranks it because it's not competitive, right? So like this, okay, Reddit is there. So that means, you know, I have told you before as well. I think you have watched my free keyword research video as well. If you did not watch it. I have explained everything in that video. So even Reddit is there. That means you user generated content. So user generated content pop-ups in the search normally when the search is little bit weak. When you do this, you get some trustworthy from Google, right? When you write this content, you know, it's a good thing because Google doesn't have really optimized content. Like I said before, Sandbox get your site normally when you target a lot of keywords and a lot of big keywords and when your website is new, right? So these keywords are less competitive. Okay, my nice looking presentation. Anyway, so this one. Okay, if you do anything, consistency is the key. If you want to grow a YouTube channel, you have to be consistent. If you want to make a blog, you have to be consistent. You have to publish content consistently. This is the key. So Google loves, or YouTube loves, and every platform loves when someone creating content, I mean quality content, consistently, and then they get a reward. So if you can publish at least 3-4 times, right, it's a good thing. Even your website is in Google Sandbox, do not stop posting content, because it will come out for sure, right? It's a test, you know. Google tests you, you know. Google think, oh, maybe this guy or maybe this website is not serious, you know, something like this. And when you write content, let's say you have a blog, try to write at least 1,200 words, at least, right? But don't lose the quality, okay? So normally when we do something consistently and every, three, 4 times every week, then we might lose the quality of the content. That happens, right? Because we have to, like, you know? So that's why don't lose the don't lose the quality, but keep publish content consistently, okay? This is my second method. If you want to know how to get out of Google Sandbox, okay? And the third one, by the way, I have something to show you, something really interesting. It's one of my websites, right? What I did. So stay till to the end, okay? So make social media properties for your website, linking to your home page. So Google likes authority. Google likes when it's not like really like crazy backlinking stuff, right? But when there are social media properties linking to your website, right? It's a normal thing, right? And it is also natural, right? When someone has a business, when someone has a niche website, whatever it is, right? Normally, there are social media properties, right? For that exact brand, right? And linking back to your website, right? It's a normal thing. So Google like this stuff. So social media is one of the big ranking factor as well, right? So do that as well. You can do a small YouTube channel connecting to your website, right? And the other one, and the last one I have, this is actually this is the last one, but this makes a lot of sense, because when you link into other authority website, you know, that looks professional and that looks normal, right? Google likes when people are not greedy, you know, for backlinks and stuff, because people don't like to backlinks. I mean, not all, like, I would like to backlink someone when it is related, and when I need to give some credits. Okay, this content I copied from, or this content I got it from this website, you know, this data, this picture, whatever it is, I actually happily, I would love to backlink, right? Because we should, right? I mean, we should give credit. So Google like this stuff, right? If you write an article, let's say, you know, Neil Patel, right? So if I am writing an article, right, sometimes Neil Patel and Backlinko, these two guys are doing some nice research, right? So everyone like this data, right? When I talk about something, when I'm writing about SEO related article, right, I can actually talk about that data, right? Then I can say, by the way, I got this data from Neil Patel. By the way, I got this data from Backlinko, right? So this is normal. This is actually not being greedy, right? Oh, Dean Patel or Neil Patel did not link me. Why should we link to them? Other people, no. Maybe if he link me, I will link him back, you know? That attitude, you know? So that's how our brain normally trying to work, you know? But try to link authority website when it is necessary, okay? Don't go and link all the big website, and you know, don't do that, because that doesn't make sense. But Google loves when we give credit. It's a nice, great thing. Sometimes when I link other website, when I do my client SEO work, right? Even my client asking, oh, why do you link to this website, blah blah blah, right? But I say, no, it's a good thing, it's a good signal to Google, right? We are not greedy, right? So when your website is in Google Sandbox, if you want to get out of Sandbox, you can do these four steps, right? So first one, I will give you a small brief before you go. Find low competitive keywords, like I showed you with Quora. Consistency. Okay, 1200 at least. Do not lose the quality. Okay, then otherwise it looks spammy anyway. You are in the sandbox, but you are doing something little bit looks like spammy, right? It's not a good thing. So don't lose the content quality, okay? And the third one is social media properties. Make all the social media property to your website, to your brand. Link your website, okay? Other one, a little bit slow, I don't know why. Link authority website, like I just explained before. I said I will show you something at end of the video, right? This is what I am showing you. Okay, this website is really, really new, okay? And I did a video about it. I ranked with one single article. And I won one of the snippet for that article, for that keyword as well, right? It was like 2 weeks, maybe 1 week. I don't even remember right now. This website did not, this is a fresh domain. I didn't even do any backlinking, nothing. I don't do this stuff now, right? But this website straight away jumped into Google SERP. Why? Why? Because I targeted really, really, really less competitive searches at the beginning. At the beginning, this is really, really the reason, if you do not want to go to Google Sandbox. So write content for really less competitive searches. Now you know how to get out of Google Sandbox. Apply these four methods. Do not give up, right? Do not stop publishing good content because of Google Sandbox, you know. Your website will go out of Google Sandbox for sure. Okay, so if you like this kind of content, you can subscribe, and if you like this video, give me a thumbs up as well. So see you in the next video.